Studio, this is The Point, 1470 AM, 95.9 FM.
It's time for Success in Real Estate with Frankie Griffin, owner and broker in charge of the Palmetto Success Team, certified residential specialist, accredited buyer representative, military relocation professional, real estate appraiser, and author of Success in Real Estate. If you are interested in buying or selling a home, investing in real estate, or having your home appraised, you will enjoy Success in Real Estate. Now, here's Frankie Griffin.
All right. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Success in Real Estate, a very special day for me, because this is one of those days. Remember, twice a year, for those of you that have been listening a while, you already know this, but if you haven't, twice a year we put real estate aside and give back to the one that really matters. And, you know, one of those shows is always our Easter show and then also our Christmas show. Well, today's going to be our Easter show, where we're going to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And, you know, because if it weren't for that, we wouldn't have a reason to live. And so what a wonderful time to celebrate. And I couldn't be any more pleased with the guest I have in studio with me today, which happens to be my own dad. Don Griffin is in studio. In fact, he has written a book, and we're going to be talking a lot about this new book he's got. But as always, we still want to make the show for you, and that is going to be about Easter. We're not going to be discussing real estate, so if somebody needs something real estate related, you can go to my website, frankiegriffin.com, contact me that way, and I'll certainly help you any way we can after the show today. But today is all about Easter, and again, in studio, I've got my dad, Don Griffin. And how you doing this morning, Pop?
I'm doing great. Glad to be here.
You look like you're having a ball.
Oh, I am.
Well, you know, Dad, you've been my dad for most of my life now.
Almost all your life.
Yeah. And, you know, you've written this book, Great Life, Great Marriage, and it's an incredible book. And I'm not saying it just because you're my dad. I'm saying it because it's a very inspirational book. It's very good. In fact, I'm quite impressed with it. And I wanted to sort of talk to you about it a little bit.
Okay.
Well, first of all, what inspired you to do this?
Well, you know, I've studied God's Word all my life, and I found that whether it's real estate or an insurance agency like I have, no matter what you do in life, you can't really separate the two if you really want to be successful. But what really prompted me to write this book is, over the years, I've watched young married couples, older married couples. It seems that age has not a lot to do with it anymore. And people struggle so much in their marriages. I see too many get-by marriages, and people come to a place where they think this is normal, but it's not normal. Because God wants good for you, and God wants to bless you, and He already has. He's made the provision for it. It's just figuring out how it works.
Well, and I got to tell you, and I've gone through, I've read the book two or three times, and I've underlined, highlighted a few things that I'd love for you to sort of talk about and expand on, if we could. But actually, before I get into that, and I should have done this earlier, but if you have any comments, any thoughts about Easter as we celebrate, we would love to have you join in with the show. The number here to call is 799-8255, 799-8255. Of course, the area code is 803 for those of you that may be outside the area code. But Pop, here's the first thing I've got that I'm looking at here in your book. In fact, it's chapter one. In fact, you've titled this chapter, As a Man Thinks, So Is He. And here's a statement you've got in here. It says, the law was powerless to remove sin and therefore powerless to save. And I've just thought that was very interesting. And then I'm going to also, sort of going with that, you've got in here, the new covenant has replaced the old, and the two covenants, law and grace, are not mixed. Jesus confirmed that these are not to be mixed when he said, nor do people put new wine into old wineskins. And, you know, that's got a lot to do with Easter, I think.
It does. It has everything to do with Easter.
So what does that mean the law was powerless to remove sin and therefore powerless to save?
Well, you know, there are two covenants in Scripture, and there are many covenants that God made with man, but the two primary covenants was, number one, the one he made with Moses at Mount Sinai, and he gave the law there. You know, it's interesting that when that law was given, that very day, 3,000 people died because of their sins. But the day that grace came at Pentecost, 3,000 people were saved. That's quite a difference.
Mm.
So when you begin to look at the law versus grace, law is a good thing. There was nothing ever wrong with the law. The law was holy. It was given by God. It was perfect. The problem was it was given to an imperfect people, and the imperfect people could not keep the law. And so when you look at the two covenants, the old covenant was really, if you wanted to downsize it, you would say the old covenant was do. It's what you got to do. You do this, God said, and I'll do that. If you do this, I will back up what you're doing. But so often people didn't do that. So the law was never intended to save anyone. It was intended to point people to the Savior, and that's Jesus Christ. And the atonement really came at the cross. It didn't come with Matthew chapter 1, verse 1. It came at the cross of Calvary when the new covenant came.
So when you're talking about the Old Testament,
yes,
is the Old Covenant. The New Testament is the New Covenant.
Yes. But I say again, if you want to study Scripture, if you want to understand it much better, you have to understand that the New Covenant didn't begin with Matthew. It began at the cross.
Well, and that's a lot of what we're going to be dealing with today. And in fact, you know, and I know this, the book you've written wasn't necessarily about Easter, but it certainly has a lot to do with Easter.
It does. So it's really the book, the reason I wrote it again was to help people understand how God's kingdom operates. So many people, when they give their lives to Jesus, that's good, that's great, because without it you are in a terrible mess. But the understanding how the kingdom operates once you are saved is what most people really don't understand. And they think, well, you're saved, that's it. No, that's just the beginning.
Well, you know, there are a lot of challenges certainly throughout the world today, and even in our personal lives, we have a lot of challenges, and this book kind of helps deal with a lot of that stuff, how we can feel comforted, how we can feel like there is a better day ahead. And we're going to be talking and exploring about all of these things. And, you know, if you have any thoughts or comments, we always want to hear from you. Love to hear it. The number in studio, if you give us a call, is 803-799-8255. Again, 799-8255. Be right back with some more Success in Real Estate.
Oh, I heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for we
Boy, I tell you, I love that song. Good, good Father. Chris Tomlin obviously sings that song. Awesome, awesome song. Great message there. And we're going to be coming in out of every break this morning with some really powerful music, I think. Well, we'd love to talk to you if you have any questions or comments, thoughts about Easter or the resurrection of Jesus. We'd love to hear from you. The number is 799-8255. Again, 803-799-8255. In fact, let's go straight to our phone lines where we've got Lakina on the phone. How you doing, Miss Lakina?
I'm doing great. I was worshiping to that song that was just on.
God bless you,
awesome.
Girl. I
God
know,
bless you, too.
I know it's way past your bedtime.
It's okay.
And
this is worth it.
Where are you calling from?
Guam.
Guam?
Yes. Way out here in the middle of the Pacific somewhere on a little tiny island.
Wow. So what time is it there in Guam?
It is 11:22 p.m. Yes, 2 hours past my bedtime. So.
Well, I am.
That is all good.
Well, I am so glad you called in, and I know we got a lot of people in Guam listening to the show.
That's awesome.
So, but what do you think so far? What do you think about Easter?
It's one of my favorite, absolute favorite. I don't even want to call it a holiday. It's life to me, you know. Easter, the resurrection, is the very reason why, you know, I'm still walking and talking and singing and praising, because Christ went to the cross for me, such a wretched person that I was, and he chose to die for me. And as I was watching to the video music, Amazing Love, How Can It Be That You, My King, Should Die For Me?
Yeah.
And all I could do was just ask him, you know, I don't understand, Lord. I don't understand. I can't comprehend it. But thank you, thank you, thank you. And my six-year-old son just asked me tonight, why did Jesus rose again, Mommy? Why did he rose again? And he said, well, first of all, because he is God Almighty, and he had to rise again so that you and I can go to heaven with him one day and have our sins forgiven, and we can conquer everything, you know, in this life. He had to rise again, and that's why we live. So,
praise God.
My favorite all-time event.
Absolutely.
Humanity.
Well, you know, it's what it's all about. And,
That's right.
It gives us the reason to face tomorrow. And
yes, amen.
You know,
amen to that.
As much as we know what's lying ahead, we can sit here and not have to even worry about it.
That's right. Our living hope, because he holds us in his right arm. He leads us. He guides us. He protects us. And he provides for us.
Praise God.
There's nothing greater than knowing and having God Almighty, you know, holding you by your right hand, you know, even when you're old. And I'm just reading that out of Psalm 73 tonight. Do I have a minute to read a couple of scriptures?
You got a minute.
Okay. Yet I am always with you. You hold me by my right hand. You guide me with your counsel. And afterward, you will take me into glory. Whom have I in heaven but you? And earth has nothing I desire beside you. And that's in Psalm 73.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Well, you know,
we have a glorious hope.
Yes, we do. And, you know, and I'm celebrating this show today with my dad, is actually when we're talking about his new book.
Hello. Hello.
How are you? And God bless you.
I'm doing super great. Hope you are.
Good. I am too. Thank you.
Now, Lakina, I know you kind of helped my dad a little bit get his book published, but you've got a book, and what's the name of your book?
From the Killing Fields Through Fields of Grace.
Wow. And yes. I got to tell you, that is a very powerful book, and to actually talk to someone that has lived through that period and dealt with those the things that you talk about in your book is just incredible. There's no question that the hand of Jesus was all over you.
Amen.
For you to even
Amen.
Survive that.
Yes, thank you, Lord. 1,000 times I should have died, but I'm still here.
Yeah. Well, tell us, because we don't have a lot of time left, but how can we find your book?
You can just Google my name, and there's a whole bunch of links that will come. You can get my book on any of those links. Amazon has it. The Loris Company has it. Books a Million. Every book links pretty much around the globe carries it.
And the name of it again?
From the Killing Fields Through Fields of Grace.
Oh,
or
yeah.
Just Google Lakeena L. King. It'll come up.
Awesome. Well, sweet, I can't thank you enough for calling. Now, is John home?
He's snoring away, yes.
What, you let him go to bed?
He's in our bedroom. I'm in the guest bedroom. He's like, can you take the call somewhere? Because he's got to get up at 4 and does his PT. You know, he's really committed to his PT. You know how that is,
well,
right?
Well, he's defending our country, and praise God.
And tell your dad congratulations. That was definitely the will of the Lord for him to have his book written, published, and shared. So I'm very, very happy for him.
Well, very good. Well, I hope you have a wonderful evening for you. And
yes.
Thank you for calling in, Ms. Lakeena.
My pleasure. God bless you guys, and happy Resurrection Weekend.
Same to you. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Again, this was Lakeena King, and awesome book if you're looking for something to read. Very good, and she's been an inspiration for me for a number of years now. But here, back in studio, we're talking with my dad, a book he's written, Great Life and a Great Marriage, and another very truly inspirational book. And you know, we're going to be talking about some things that are in there, giving you kind of some highlights, if you will. But if you have any thoughts about the resurrection, we'd love to hear from you. The number in studio again is 803-799-8255. Again, 799-8255. And, Dad, you know, we've got probably a little bit under a minute right now, but I just wanted to sort of read another piece you've got in your book that I just think is awesome, and we may have to get into it a little bit on the next segment. But here's what it says: For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all men. And then you kind of write about that verse: grace and Jesus cannot be separated; they are both one and the same. Grace is the embodiment of Jesus, and Jesus is the empowerment of grace. And I really want to kind of get your thoughts on when you say the empowerment of grace. Because, and really, what is grace, I guess? But well, let me ask, Kevin, how much time we got? We got 30 seconds. So there's no way you can talk in less than 30 seconds, I'm sure. But what is grace, real quick?
What is grace? Grace is Jesus. You know, again, you can't separate them. It's not some sloppy agape. It's not some little something.
Well, we're going to talk more about this when we come back. Love to hear from you. 799-8255. Be right back with some more Success in Real Estate.
I try to hold on to this world with everything I have, but I feel the weight of what it brings and the hurt that tries to grab. Many trials that seem to never end. His word declares this truth, that we will enter in this rest with wonders anew. But I hold on to this hope and the promise that he brings, that there will be a place with no more suffering. There will be a day with no more tears, no and no more fears. There will be a day when the burdens of this place will be walking on your own. There has never been a step, but you've walked that road alone. Trouble, so don't lose your heart, 'cause joy and peace he brings, and the beauty that's in store. How is the hurt of life's sting?
There Will Be a Day, of course, by Jeremy Camp. Another awesome song, inspirational. But there will be a day when we don't have to worry about the pain, the suffering, the tears, because it's coming. And you know, you look at what's going around the world nowadays, you're seeing a lot of the prophecy have already come to fruition. And I just believe that day is coming very soon, and love to hear what you think about that. What are your thoughts about the resurrection, or what we're talking about, any of the stuff we're talking about today? Again, you can certainly call in. The number's 803-799-8255, 799-8255. In fact, and I've got my dad, Don Griffin, is in studio. And we're talking about a book he has written. It's a new book, Great Life and Great Marriage. And a lot of it's got, a lot of it is dealing with exactly what we're talking about today. So it's a really good book, very inspirational. But let me get your thoughts on this. I mean, you know, we were just listening to something, There Will Be a Day. And, you know, and as I said, you know, I think that day's coming soon. And what are your thoughts?
Well, I think the day is coming very soon, but we have to understand that a lot of people get very confused. The church belongs to Christ Jesus. That's what he purchased at the cross. And, you know, anyone, let me say this, anyone that's not a part of the church today, all you have to do is say yes to Jesus. You don't have to make any big deal about it. Just say, yes, Jesus, save me, and he'll do it quickly. But he's going to call his church out. And I don't think that day is going to be very long. The signs are all around us. I think it's going to happen. It'll happen in the twinkling of an eye. And those who are in the grave, they'll be raised first. And we who are alive will follow. That's in Thessalonians. So it's going to happen. It's going to happen very soon. But, you know, what I'm listening to the Lord say to me this morning is there's a lot of you out there that you're not so concerned about what's in the future. You're concerned about what's right now. Your life's hurting right now.
Mm-hmm.
Your marriage is hurting right now. You're concerned about your finances. You're concerned about your future. And I want to say to you that Christ has made the payment for all these things that you're concerned about this morning, because he loves you. He's not mad at you this morning. God loves you. And I want you to understand that. And that's the purpose of this book, really, is people can understand, you know, how you can make the kingdom operate and work for you now, right now.
Yeah, and you know what? And, you know, in chapter 3 of your book, in fact, it's titled, You Have Kingdom Rights.
Exactly.
And what rights do we have? And talk to, what is it, when you say we have kingdom rights, what are we talking about?
Well, remember in Colossians chapter 1:7, and it says, and he rescued us from the domain of darkness and transferred us into his kingdom. So when we are saved, when we say yes to Jesus, we're not on the outside looking in anymore. You know, when Jesus preached the Sermon on the Mount, he said, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added to you. Now, that was before the cross. And he made the propitiation for that. He made the appropriation for that at the cross of Calvary. And so now it belongs to you. So now you're in the kingdom. The kingdom's in you, in fact. The word abides in you. And so you have these things, but if you don't know what you have, then you're in big trouble. And I would say today that most of the people, most of the church, really don't understand what they do have. Let me just read a verse to you real quick. It said, now I say, as long as the heir is a child, he doesn't differ at all from a slave, although he's the owner of everything. And I find that's what most Christians are today. They're like children in the kingdom. They really don't understand their kingdom rights. And so the enemy runs over from pillar to post. And that's why so many people are struggling today. You don't need to be struggling all the time. You need to be living in enjoying your life and your marriage and your job and your opportunities, and not struggling.
Yeah, you know, and the sort of caveat with onto that, you've got in here, one day you will actually be in the kingdom, but now you're of the kingdom, possessing and having ownership of all the riches it contains.
Well, exactly. When Christ comes back to this earth, guess what? The church is coming with him. Again, this is two separate events. When he calls the church out unto himself, and then when he returns, that'll be after the tribulation or to end the tribulation period. But guess what? The church is coming with him.
And what a glorious day. And that's what we're talking about. There will be a day when all our fears, and you know, let me just speak on that. And you know, a lot of people are in so much pain, just emotional pain. And it's got a lot to do with just there's this huge void in their life, and if something's going to fill this void, and what you fill it with is going to determine your future.
Well, exactly. As a man thinks, so is he, Proverbs 23:7. So what is your mind on this morning? What do you think about? You know, we need to think about, what are we thinking about? When you get up in the morning, what are you thinking about? Are you looking for a good day? Are you looking for just another ho-hum day? What are you looking at? So you have to learn to get your mind set on the things of God. And when you begin to set your mind on the promises, you'll find the promises will begin to work for you. But if you set your mind on all the problems, all the challenges, all the things that are negative, guess what? That's what's going to be a part of your life, and that's what will dictate how your days go.
Well, and, you know, the biggest thing that Jesus kind of preached on to help people become better, stronger, happier people, it's just you got to have faith that his word is real, his word will prevail, and it's just about faith. And a lot of people have a problem just, faith is not that easy for a lot of people, apparently.
No, but faith is real. And as faith is not something you've got to work up, faith is something you have to have. And you do have faith.
Well, we're going to continue that conversation. Our last segment, number to call, 799-8255. Be right back with Success in Real Estate.
One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. The word became flesh, the light shined among us, his glory revealed. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away.
Success in Real Estate. And again, what another glorious day by Casting Crowns, another wonderful song. I love that. And, you know, we're talking about Easter, or the meaning of Easter, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And I just love doing the Easter show. And I'm very fortunate and blessed this year to actually have my dad in studio, because my dad lives in Georgia. And so I don't get to see him as much as we'd love to, but this is really, really an exciting time for me. And we get to talk about his brand new book called A Great Life, Great Marriage. And, you know, Dad, this is our last segment, and I know you had some notes or thoughts that you wanted to share, and so let's hear those.
Well, I just wanted to share with the people today that the Word, God's Word, is the thing that's going to change your life. You know, and it's really the only thing that's going to ever change your life. I received this in the email, so I don't really know where it came from, but I just wanted to share it very quickly. And it's talking about the Word, God's Word. It says, you can take God's Word as a medicine with no danger of taking an overdose. You don't have to buy it. It's free. And whatever sickness or disease you're suffering from, God's Word can cure it. It's effective for any condition. It has satisfactory results. If they're not obtained right away, then all you need to do is double the dose. And like any medicine, God's Word has to be taken to be effective. It won't work sitting on the shelf. It must be taken according to directions. And if you'll follow God's directions as faithfully as you would your human doctor, you'll see and receive wonderful results.
Amen. Awesome. And, you know, we've been talking, you know, about a lot of different stuff, and I really loved, we could spend another 2 or 3 hours just talking about some of the things you've got in your book, but I wanted to make sure everybody does know how they can get a copy of this book. So I know you've got a website. What's that website?
The website is donandpenny.com. If you just type that in, it'll take you directly to the website.
Don and Penny, D-O-N and A-N-D, and then Penny, P-E-N-N-Y.com. And, of course, we will have this on our website certainly by Monday, if not later this afternoon. But just go to donandpenny.com, and, you know, there's a lot of good stuff on that site, and one of those being, you know, you do a blog.
I do a blog each Friday, yes.
So once a week you do a blog.
Yes.
And, you know, and I was looking at the last one you had and actually highlighted part of what you've got in this blog. And it says, I got to put my glasses on. I can't see as good as I thought I used to. But anyway. It says, the blood has now been supplied, but it is up to us to make sure it has been applied. His death, his shed blood, and his resurrection from the grave didn't destroy a part of the curse. It completely destroyed all of the curse over everyone who chose to place their faith in him. So, what are you saying? It didn't destroy part of it, but you're saying all of it.
Destroyed all of it. You know, most of us are taught that it destroyed sin as relates to salvation. And if it didn't, then we wouldn't have anything to be here talking about today, but it did. But also, when the curse came, sickness came. When the curse came, disease came. When the curse came, poverty came. Everything that's evil and bad came because of the curse. But you see, Christ broke the curse at the cross, all of the curse. And so you don't have to walk around sick. You don't have to walk around broke. You don't have to walk around without, because God's an abundant God. And he said in John 10:10, I came that you may have life and have it, what? More abundantly. God wants you to have an abundant life, an abundant marriage, a fun time. He wants you to be able to laugh and enjoy your life with your husband and your wife and your children. And it's all a part of what happens at the atonement at the cross.
And, you know, the most critical words Jesus spoke right at the end is, it is finished.
It is finished. It's a finished work. He's not still trying to do something. He's not sitting in heaven deciding if he's going to do something for you or not doing something for you. He's already done it. But you have to lay claim to it by the promises of God, which are yes and amen through Christ Jesus.
When he says it is finished, is he relating to the old covenant is finished? We're now in the new.
Exactly. It ended one chapter. It began a great, wonderful new chapter that we're in today, and that's the new covenant of grace. We live in grace today. And thankfully today, your sins are not computed to you, but that Christ took them on the cross, every sin.
So now, if I'm having issues, I'm having problems, I'm having challenges, and I just feel like I can't get my life together, and I hear what you said for the last hour, but is it truly just as simple as saying, forgive me, and I can just move on?
Well, that's salvation, and it is just that simple. You don't have to work it up. You don't have to wait till you get good. You never will get good enough to be saved. Nobody will. And you know what we do is we put our eyes on people that are saved sometimes, and we look at their inadequacies, and we look at them when they fall and falter. But you know, we're all on the mold of life, and God's got the wheel turning, and He's changing us from glory to glory. So that's just a part of what's going on. We're not perfect people yet, except in the spirit.
Okay. Well, then I want to go back to a couple of things back in your book, and this time I'm actually looking in the chapter that, let's see, you've got it titled, Expect Good Things Because Christ Loves You. And it says, now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Now that's in Hebrews. But then you've got a note here. Notice that the word hope has an ED attached to the end of it, thus denoting a past tense. You began with hope, but the ED says that it is now turned into faith. What are you saying there?
Exactly. Let me say this. There's probably a lot of people, I hope not a lot, but there are people out there this morning listening to our voices that really you've almost lost hope. And let me say to you this, just stop. Just stop. And give up and give in to the Lord, and hope will begin once again. But you don't stop with hope. You want to go into that arena of faith where you win the fights and you win the battles and you win your marriage back and you win over alcohol and you win over everything that's been holding you in bondage. Remember, the psalmist said this, that the Lord is my salvation, the stronghold of my life. You need to turn your thinking around if you're in a stronghold of any kind. And remember that God's, let Him be your stronghold. Your words are powerful. Understand that you need to begin to guard your words as you guard your heart. Guard what you're listening to, who you're listening to, who you surround yourself with. Because Proverbs 18:22 says, life and death is in the power of your tongue. So what you're saying is what you will receive.
Awesome. And, you know, one of the things, and I know, I think hopefully we've got a couple minutes left, but... you know, one of the biggest issues you tend to see a lot today with people, and I mean they're taking medication for it and going to the doctor, and it's anxiety. A lot of people, there's so much anxiety in life, in the world, and, you know, anxiety, to me, and I'd love to see what you think about this, but, you know, Jesus said you'd be anxious for nothing. And anxiety is nothing but Satan, and to me, that's sin.
Well, let's look at it this way. Anxiety is a result of fear. You're concerned about something, and it has to be something that you really, you think God can, but you're not sure He will. But let me tell you, if it's anything good, God's already done it. He's not waiting. He's already done it. So I would encourage you, if you're listening today, to go and just go to our website, donandpenny.com, or just type in Great Life, Great Marriage, and this will pop up and take you to several websites where this book can be purchased. I don't even know the cost of it right now. But anyway, it'd be well worth a few dollars to spend, because this book will teach you how the kingdom operates, and it'll work for you.
And incredibly inspirational book. It's an awesome book. And, you know, for those of you that are listening, and you're familiar with me, and, you know, go to my Facebook page. You'll see the book there. I've got a status about it, Great Life, Great Marriage. You'll also see Dad's website, again, donandpenny.com. And go on there and just read the blog. Read a few of these blogs, and I'm telling you, you'll be incredibly blessed. You'll feel better. You'll understand things much better. But thank you so much for joining in and listening to us today. We love the show, Dad. Thank you for coming in. Hope you have a wonderful weekend. You've been listening to Success in Real Estate.